Let me tell you something. You stop saying this foolishness. You stop saying this foolishness is in a man's nature to cheat. You're encouraging your own husband then. You're encouraging your own boyfriends and fiancé to go and cheat on you. To go and cheat on you. These days, if you're a female, you run to your friend and say, "He's cheating on me. I can't deal with it. He's cheating on me." The first advice you're going to get is, "Girl, every man cheat. It's in a man's nature to cheat." Let me tell you something. We are not encouraging our men, especially the ones who are supposed to be God-fearing. We're not encouraging them to do what's right, especially if they are married or unmarried, because fornication is just as bad. Well, in fact, let's just stick it to the marriage, because adultery is just, yes. You're not encouraging the man take a sister hand, walk down the aisle and say, "This is the woman I want to spend the rest of my life with. I'm going to be faithful to her through thick and thin, for sick in sickness and in health, in everything. I'm going to be faithful to her and be her king." Then everybody keeps saying, then he steps out of his marriage, and then everybody keep coming to give the girl advice. "Oh, it's in a man's nature to cheat. Just forgive him. It's in his nature to cheat." Oh, as a man, your word, you should stand on your word. You go to the altar and say you will be faithful to this woman. You're supposed to be faithful to her. Forget about the nature. Once you get married, you have abandoned your nature. You've hung up and abandoned the dead jersey, that cheating behavior, that nature. When you get married, you give up that nature. What is wrong with you people? Just because people walk around saying it's in a man's nature to cheat. No, if you're married, it shouldn't be. It should no longer be in your nature to go and cheat. The heck? And a lot of you women over there keep saying that thing even when the man is married. Let me tell you something. If you're a wife and you're accepting it, you're only sending your husband to hell. You ain't helping to send him to hell. He must just go and be sleeping with other women. You're not worried about yourself too. You think every time he goes out there, he's using protection. You not know. You know, it's not even so okay to keep cheating, whether your boyfriend, fiance, or wife, or whatever, or in such relationship. It's not even okay to cheat, because you will never be happy. There's always going to be drama. Women, we are already emotional creatures, and then you want to juggle 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 100. I was reading a blog the last time. One man slept with 300 women. What are you looking for? What are you looking for? You've tasted every kind of, yeah. And what are you looking for? What was it in that one woman that attracted you, that made you to fall in love so much that it's not keeping you? If even she's not doing the same thing anymore that caused you to be attracted to her, are you still the same man she met from the beginning? Nobody remains the same. That thing is like roller coaster, man. That thing is like roller coaster. Relationship is up and down. It's up and down. But cheating shouldn't be part of it. Cheating should not be part of it. If you decide to go out, then be done with it. Be done with it. In a man's nature to cheat, you're supposed to abandon that. Once you get married, y'all stop encouraging these brothers. It's not cool. It's not cool. It's in your nature, my foot. If it's in your nature, as long as it's still in your nature, don't marry nobody's daughter. And if you're a woman, if it's in your nature to cheat too, don't get married. You're not ready.